Hi, I'm Simon. I work at Salesforce. I'm on the same team as Peter, who just talked about dependency management. And I'm going to talk a little more about our monorepo and our experience over the last 4 years with this monorepo. So we started this project about 4 years ago. We are a team at Salesforce that owns libraries that get used in microservices, and we've seen all the pains our customers have with a mini repo model where the libraries get pushed to a package manager, and then the projects that use the libraries have to download them from the package manager, and you know, various problems associated with that. So we thought, let's just create a monorepo and put everybody in there, and we solve a whole bunch of problems at once. And so we just started this project. We created a new repo. We took our libraries, we had like 10 repos or so, we put them in the monorepo, we called it a monorepo, and it was great. We found Bazel, Bazel seemed to work, it was version 0.18, and then we went to BazelCon in 2018, and we were super excited, and we talked about a bunch of stuff, and oh, by the way, that's typical interaction between Peter and me, where I'm proposing an awesome idea, and Peter is like, no man, don't work on it, it's not going to work. He's a little negative these days, but nice guy otherwise. Anyway, so we talked about adoption at this talk, and I think we were a little overly optimistic because we thought, you know, all these teams are going to show up and they want to be in this repo and it's going to be awesome. And, you know, we did have some growth. So we have 40 teams-ish in the repo now. But 4 years, 40 teams, you know, it's not that amazing. We have around 300 services or so. So we got 80 out of those. So a monorepo that's kind of small and doesn't have the majority of services, is that really a monorepo or is that just another repo that's just kind of sitting there? So our problem is convincing teams to move into the monorepo. We don't have a mandate at Salesforce to use the monorepo. So the teams kind of decide, yeah, I want to move in there, or no, I'd rather stay in my own little thing. We have some recognition from management that this is a useful thing to have a monorepo, but no mandate. So I want to talk a little bit about that, our experience to have a monorepo and not having a way of getting teams to move in. So it's not really related to Bazel so much, but I put that on the title of my talk, so then my talk would get accepted here. But Bazel is actually great at our scale. Bazel just works. It's awesome. We have almost only good things to say about Bazel. So I'm just going to go over some things we learned. And in case you're also thinking of starting a grassroots monorepo, you may face similar issues. So I have these categories. The top three are kind of must-have features, and the bottom ones are customer objections when we ask them to move in. So developer experience is just a big bucket, obviously. That could be anything, but it's really hard to actually convince a team to move in if you have worse developer experience. I mean, things just like IDE, right? How to use your IDE, how quick does it start up, how easy is it to make changes? I mean, it's hard to beat the single repo experience for a developer. So it's just kind of challenging. Although IntelliJ works pretty well. So the first thing we ran into, so we are not a build team, we just own these libraries. And like I said, we just created a repo, called it the monorepo. And then we realized all these other teams we depend on, like CI most importantly, but also code coverage team, static analysis, everything. They had no idea how to handle a monorepo. Like, we were probably the first to have a code owners file. And so it took a long time to make them understand that now there's a repo there with more than one, or with many projects, but owned by different teams. So this took way longer than what we thought it would take. So it's good to just start talking to other teams early if you're trying to do this. Then we realized, although we're trying to get out of the package manager thing, you know, we want everybody in the repo, we still need integration with a package manager, because when we ask teams to move in, they say, great, I have a library and a service, but I have other users of my library. How can I how can I do that? And then we say, well, all the users move in at the same time. And then they say, no, that's too much work for us. We don't want to deal with it. So in the end, we had to make sure that the artifacts built by Bazel in the repo are still consumable outside. So we spent a bunch of time on that. IDE, then we spend a lot of time on trying to get Bazel and Eclipse to work, because Salesforce is traditionally Eclipse-based, although it's changing a little now. So we thought, when we talked to teams and we asked them to A, move into a new repo, B, change the build tool, and C, change your IDE, that would be just too much. So in the end, though, given that we are a small team, we're still trying to get Eclipse working. Peter is still working on it. And it is working, but it's hard to beat IntelliJ. So in the end, we standardize on IntelliJ. And we're having these difficult conversations. Flaky tests, I just put that there because I'm just curious if anybody here really solved flaky tests. Please come and talk to us, because it's a huge, it's just a problem for us. Then, in the interest of time, I'm going to skip these two. Reduced workload. So it turns out this is actually the main selling point. So this is what Peter talked about. So we're doing all these things for our users, like the upgrades, the JDKs, Docker images, all the libraries. That's all done by us, so that our users don't have to do that. If you're in the monorepo, you never have to upgrade Spring. You never have to upgrade Spring Boot. We'll do it for you. We change your code. You know, if there's an API change, we just do that. You don't have to deal with it. And it turns out that this is the main selling point of the monorepo. So this kind of works when we talk to teams. We tell them, yeah, maybe you know your IDE is going to be a little different, maybe not quite as easy to use, but you don't have to do all this. And so that's a good one. But it requires good test coverage. Because we merge PRs when tests are green. And if you don't have tests, well, that's a problem, because we may break you. Performance scale is a common objection brought up when we talk to teams. A, build tool performance, and also the VCS performance. And we all know that Bazel is awesome at the build tool performance. So this is where Bazel has been really great. We have no concerns, and we just tell them the history of Bazel and how it came from Google and how Google has huge monorepos, or one huge monorepo, and so that's good. VCS, we spend a lot of time on Git scale and understanding how Git works, and just understanding what could go wrong with Git and scale. And so now we only allow small files into the repo. We have a way of mapping larger files into the build, but they don't go into the monorepo. And we also, a year ago or so, refactored our tooling, so it's not specific. So it's not coupled to this monorepo. So we now actually have two repos. One is for Golang, one is for Java. And we have the tooling sitting outside. And so that also kind of helps with discussions, because we know we can't move, we may not be able to move 300 services into a single Git repository. But we could easily have two. And so maybe having a small number of larger repos is the way to go. Okay, then other customer objections we have to deal with. First, they're just developers who don't like monorepos. They're just not sure why. But we just learned to walk away from that. And we had cases where once that developer left the team would come back to us and say, actually, we do want to move in. And so that worked pretty well. Training, you know, learning a new build tool, obviously, that's it's difficult, or can be difficult. So we have really good support. We have a Slack channel. Our team is distributed, and we are always on Slack pretty much to help answer questions. There's nothing worse than a frustrated developer who can't build. So we try to deal with that really quickly. And also, some teams say, we would love to migrate in, but we don't have time, can't do it. So we just offer to do it for them. We say, sure, you know, give us your code. We'll spend a week, migrate it into the repo. And sometimes then they have a different reason, because they're just trying to not migrate in. But sometimes that works. So feature requests, this is the last one. So every team has different feature requests, obviously. Everybody wants the same flow that they're used to outside, but in our repo. And so we try to accommodate that. The only thing we've learned pretty quickly is that one-offs are bad. And so we try to implement the features in such a way that then every team can benefit who's already in the repo. And that has also worked pretty well. That's all I have for today. Thank you very much.